Nehemiah chapter 3. Then Eliashib the high priest arose with his brothers the priests and built the sheep gate. They consecrated it and hung its doors. They consecrated the wall to the tower of the hundred and the tower of Hanano. And next to them, the men of Jericho built. And next to them, Zakur the son of Imri built. Now the sons of Hassanah built the fish gate. They laid its beams and hung its doors with its bolts and bars. And next to them, Meremoth, the son of Uriah, the son of Hakaz, made repairs. And next to him, Meshullam, the son of Berechiah, the son of Meshezabel, made repairs. And next to him, Zadok, the son of Bena, also made repairs. Moreover, next to him, the Tekoites made repairs, but their nobles did not support the work of their masters. And Joiada, the son of Paseah, and Meshullam, the son of Besadiah, repaired the old gate. They laid its beams and hung its doors, with its bolts and its bars. Next to them, Melatiah the Gibeonite, and Jadon the Meronothite, the men of Gibeon and of Mizpah, also made repairs for the official seat of the governor of the province beyond the river. Next to him, Uziel, the son of Harhiah, of the goldsmiths, made repairs. And next to him, Hananiah, one of the perfumers, made repairs, and they restored Jerusalem as far as the broad wall. And next to them, Rephaiah the son of Hur, the official of half the district of Jerusalem, made repairs. Next to them, Jediah the son of Harumaph made repairs opposite his house. And next to him, Hattush the son of Hashabneah made repairs. Malchijah the son of Harim and Hashub the son of Pahath Moab repaired another section and the tower of furnaces. And next to him, Shalom, the son of Halohesh, the official of half the district of Jerusalem, made repairs, he and his daughters. Hanun and the inhabitants of Zanoah repaired the valley gate. They built it and hung its doors with its bolts and its bars, and 1,000 cubits of the wall to the refuse gate. And Malchijah, the son of Rechem, the official of the district of Beth Hakron, repaired the refuse gate. He built it and hung its doors with its bolts and its bars. Shalom, the son of Kol-Hoze, the official of the district of Mizpah, repaired the fountain gate. He built it, covered it, and hung its doors with its bolts and its bars, and the wall of the pool of Shelah at the king's garden as far as the steps that descend from the city of David. After him, Nehemiah, the son of Azbuk, official of half the district of Beth-Zur, made repairs as far as a point opposite the tombs of David, and as far as the artificial pool and the house of the mighty men. After him, the Levites carried out repairs under Rehum, the son of Bani. Next to him, Hashabiah, the official of half the district of Keilah, carried out repairs for his district. After him, their brothers carried out repairs under Bavai, the son of Hanadad, official of the other half of the district of Keilah. And next to him, Ezer, the son of Jeshua, the official of Mizpah, repaired another section in front of the ascent of the armory at the angle. After him, Baruch, the son of Zabai, zealously repaired another section from the angle to the doorway of the house of Eliashib, the high priest. After him, Meremoth, the son of Uriah, the son of Hakaz, repaired another section from the doorway of Eliashib's house, even as far as the end of his house. And after him, the priests, the men of the valley, carried out repairs. After them, Benjamin and Hashub carried out repairs in front of their house. After them, Azariah, the son of Maaseiah, son of Ananiah, carried out repairs beside his house. After him, Binui, the son of Hanadad, repaired another section from the house of Azariah as far as the angle and as far as the corner. Palal, the son of Uzai, made repairs in front of the angle and the tower projecting from the upper house of the king, which is by the court of the guard. After him, Padiah, the son of Parash, made repairs. And the temple servants living in Ophel made repairs as far as the front of the water gate toward the east and the projecting tower. After him, the Tekoites repaired another section in front of the great projecting tower and as far as the wall of Ophel. Above the horse gate, the priests carried out repairs, each in front of his house. After them, Zadok, the son of Immer, carried out repairs in front of his house. And after him, Shemaiah, the son of Shechaniah, the keeper of the east gate, carried out repairs. After him, Hananiah, the son of Shelemiah, and Hanan, the sixth son of Zaleph, repaired another section. After him, Meshullam, the son of Berechiah, carried out repairs in front of his own quarters. After him, Malchijah, one of the goldsmiths, carried out repairs as far as the house of the temple servants and of the merchants, in front of the inspection gate and as far as the upper room of the corner. And between the upper room of the corner and the sheep gate, the goldsmiths and the merchants carried out repairs. Nehemiah chapter 4. Now it came about that when Sambalat heard that we were rebuilding the wall, he became furious and very angry and mocked the Jews. And he spoke in the presence of his brothers and the wealthy men of Samaria and said, "What are these feeble Jews doing? Are they going to restore it for themselves? Can they offer sacrifices? Can they finish in a day? Can they revive the stones from the dusty rubble, even the burned ones?" Now Tobiah the Ammonite was near him, and he said, "Even what they are building, if a fox should jump on it, he would break their stone wall down. Hear, O our God, how we are despised. Return their reproach on their own heads and give them up for plunder in the land of captivity. Do not forgive their iniquity and let not their sin be blotted out before you, for they have demoralized the builders." So we built the wall, and the whole wall was joined together to half its height, for the people had a mind to work. Now it came about when Sambalat and Tobiah, the Arabs, the Ammonites, and the Ashdodites heard that the repair of the walls of Jerusalem went on and that the breaches began to be closed, they were very angry. And all of them conspired together to come and fight against Jerusalem and to cause a disturbance in it. But we prayed to our God, and because of them, we set up a guard against them day and night. Thus in Judah it was said, "The strength of the burden bearers is failing, yet there is much rubbish, and we ourselves are unable to rebuild the wall." And our enemies said, "They will not know or see until we come among them, kill them, and put a stop to the work." And it came about when the Jews who lived near them came up and told us 10 times, "They will come up against us from every place where you may turn." Then I stationed men in the lowest parts of the space behind the wall and the exposed places. And I stationed the people in families with their swords, spears, and bows. When I saw their fear, I rose and spoke to the nobles, the officials, and the rest of the people. "Do not be afraid of them. Remember the Lord who is great and awesome, and fight for your brothers, your sons, your daughters, your wives, and your houses." And it happened when our enemies heard that it was known to us and that God had frustrated their plan, then all of us returned to the wall, each one to his work. And it came about from that day on that half of my servants carried on the work, while half of them held the spears, the shields, the bows, and the breastplates, and the captains were behind the whole house of Judah. Those who were rebuilding the wall and those who carried burdens took their load with one hand, doing the work, and the other holding a weapon. As for the builders, each wore his sword girded at his side as he built, while the trumpeter stood near me. And I said to the nobles, the officials, and the rest of the people, "The work is great and extensive, and we are separated on the wall far from one another. At whatever place you hear the sound of the trumpet, rally to us there. Our God will fight for us." So we carried on the work with half of them holding spears from dawn until the stars appeared. At that time I also said to the people, "Let each man with his servant spend the night within Jerusalem, so that they may be a guard for us by night and a laborer by day." So neither I, my brothers, my servants, nor the men of the guard who followed me, none of us removed our clothes. Each took his weapon, even to the water. Nehemiah chapter 5. Now there was a great outcry of the people and of their wives against their Jewish brothers. For there were those who said, "We, our sons and our daughters are many. Therefore let us get grain that we may eat and live." And there were others who said, "We are mortgaging our fields, our vineyards, and our houses that we might get grain because of the famine." Also, there were those who said, "We have borrowed money for the king's tax on our fields and our vineyards. And now our flesh is like the flesh of our brothers, our children, and like their children. Yet behold, we are forcing our sons and our daughters to be slaves, and some of our daughters are forced into bondage already. And we are helpless because our fields and vineyards belong to others." Then I was very angry when I had heard their outcry and these words. And I consulted with myself and contended with the nobles and the rulers and said to them, "You are exacting usury, each from his brother." Therefore, I held a great assembly against them. And I said to them, "We, according to our ability, have redeemed our Jewish brothers who were sold to the nations. Now would you even sell your brothers, that they may be sold to us? Then they were silent and could not find a word to say. Again I said, the thing which you are doing is not good. Should you not walk in the fear of our God because of the reproach of the nations, our enemies? And likewise I, my brothers and my servants, are lending them money and grain. Please, let us leave off this usury. Please give back to them this very day their fields, their vineyards, their olive groves, and their houses, also the hundredth part of the money and of the grain, the new wine, and the oil that you are exacting from them. Then they said, we will give it back, and will require nothing from them. We will do exactly as you say. So I called the priests and took an oath from them that they would do according to this promise. I also shook out the front of my garment and said, thus may God shake out every man from his house and from his possessions who does not fulfill this promise. Even thus may he be shaken out and emptied. And all the assembly said, amen, and they praised the Lord. Then the people did according to this promise. Moreover, from the day that I was appointed to be their governor in the land of Judah, from the 20th year to the 32nd year of King Artaxerxes, for 12 years neither I nor my kinsmen have eaten the governor's food allowance. But the former governors who were before me laid burdens on the people and took from them bread and wine, besides 40 shekels of silver. Even their servants domineered the people. But I did not do so because of the fear of God. And I also applied myself to the work on this wall. We did not buy any land, and all my servants were gathered there for the work. Moreover, there were at my table 150 Jews and officials, besides those who came to us from the nations that were around us. Now that which was prepared for each day was one ox and six choice sheep. Also birds were prepared for me. And once in 10 days all sorts of wine were furnished in abundance. Yet for all this I did not demand the governor's food allowance, because the servitude was heavy on this people. Remember me, O my God, for good, according to all that I have done for this people. Nehemiah chapter 6. Now it came about when it was reported to Sambalat, Tobiah, to Geshem the Arab, and to the rest of our enemies that I had rebuilt the wall and that no breach remained in it, although at that time I had not set up the doors at the gates, that Sambalat and Geshem sent a message to me, saying, come, let us meet together at Shephiram in the plain of Ono. But they were planning to harm me. So I sent messengers to them, saying, I am doing a great work and I cannot come down. Why should the work stop while I leave it and come down to you? And they sent messages to me 4 times in this manner. And I answered them in the same way. Then Sambalat sent his servant to me in the same manner a 5th time with an open letter in his hand. In it was written, it is reported among the nations. And Geshemu says that you and the Jews are planning to rebel. Therefore, you are rebuilding the wall. And you are to be their king according to these reports. And you have appointed prophets to proclaim in Jerusalem concerning you, a king is in Judah. And now it will be reported to the king according to these reports. So come now, let us take counsel together. Then I sent a message to him, saying, such things as you are saying have not been done, but you are inventing them in your own mind. For all of them were trying to frighten us, thinking they will become discouraged with the work and it will not be done. But now, O God, strengthen my hands. And when I entered the house of Shemaiah, the son of Deliah, son of Mehetabel, who was confined at home, he said, let us meet together in the house of God within the temple, and let us close the doors of the temple, for they are coming to kill you, and they are coming to kill you at night. But I said, should a man like me flee? And could one such as I go into the temple to save his life? I will not go in. Then I perceived that surely God had not sent him. But he uttered his prophecy against me because Tobiah and Sambalat had hired him. He was hired for this reason, that I might become frightened and act accordingly in sin, so that they might have an evil report in order that they could reproach me. Remember, O my God, Tobiah and Sambalat according to these works of theirs, and also Noadiah, the prophetess, and the rest of the prophets who were trying to frighten me. So the wall was completed on the 25th of the month of Elul in 52 days. And it came about when all our enemies heard of it and all the nations surrounding us saw it, they lost their confidence. For they recognized that this work had been accomplished with the help of our God. And in those days many letters went from the nobles of Judah to Tobiah, and Tobiah's letters came to them. For many in Judah were bound by oath to him, because he was the son-in-law of Shechaniah, the son of Ara, and his son, Jehohanan, had married the daughter of Meshullam, the son of Berechiah. Moreover, they were speaking about his good deeds in my presence and reported my words to him. Then Tobiah sent letters to frighten me. Nehemiah chapter 7. Now it came about when the wall was rebuilt, and I had set up the doors, and the gatekeepers, and the singers, and the Levites were appointed, that I put Hanani, my brother, and Hananiah, the commander of the fortress, in charge of Jerusalem, for he was a faithful man and feared God more than many. Then I said to them, "Do not let the gates of Jerusalem be opened until the sun is hot, and while they are standing guard, let them shut and bolt the doors. Also appoint guards from the inhabitants of Jerusalem, each at his post, and each in front of his own house." Now the city was large and spacious, but the people in it were few, and the houses were not built. Then my God put it into my heart to assemble the nobles, the officials, and the people to be enrolled by genealogies. Then I found the book of the genealogy of those who came up first, in which I found the following record. These are the people of the province who came up from the captivity of the exiles, whom Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, had carried away, and who returned to Jerusalem and Judah, each to his city, who came with Zerubbabel, Jeshua, Nehemiah, Azariah, Ramah, Nahamani, Mordecai, Bilshan, Mispereth, Bigvai, Nahum, Bena. The number of men of the people of Israel, the sons of Parash, 2,172, the sons of Shephatiah, 372, the sons of Era, 652, the sons of Pahath Moab, of the sons of Jeshua and Joab, 2,818, the sons of Elam, 1,254, the sons of Zattu, 845, the sons of Zakai, 760, the sons of Binui, 648, the sons of Bebai, 628, the sons of Azgad, 2,322, the sons of Adonikam, 667, the sons of Bigvai, 2,067, the sons of Adin, 655, the sons of Atur of Hezekiah, 98, the sons of Hashum, 328, the sons of Bezai, 324, the sons of Harif, 112, the sons of Gibeon, 95, the men of Bethlehem and Netophah, 188, the men of Anathoth, 128, the men of Beth-Azmaveth, 42, the men of Kiriath-Jearim, Chephirah, and Beeroth, 743, the men of Ramah and Geba, 621, the men of Michmas, 122, the men of Bethel and Ai, 123, the men of the other Nebo, 52, the sons of the other Elam, 1,254, the sons of Harim, 320, the men of Jericho, 345, the sons of Lod, Hadid, and Ono, 721, the sons of Sana, 3,930, the priests, the sons of Jediah, of the house of Jeshua, 973, the sons of Immer, 1,052, the sons of Pashur, 1,247, the sons of Harim, 1,017, the Levites, the sons of Jeshua, of Kadmiel, of the sons of Hodavah, 74, the singers, the sons of Asaph, 148, the gatekeepers, the sons of Shalom, the sons of Atur, the sons of Talmon, the sons of Akub, the sons of Hatita, the sons of Shobai, 138, the temple servants, the sons of Ziha, the sons of Hasufa, the sons of Tabaoth, the sons of Keros, the sons of Sia, the sons of Padan, the sons of Libana, the sons of Hagabah, the sons of Shalmai, the sons of Hanan, the sons of Gedel, the sons of Gehar, the sons of Rea, the sons of Rezin, the sons of Nakoda, the sons of Gazam, the sons of Uza, the sons of Paseah, the sons of Besai, the sons of Munim, the sons of Nefushesim, the sons of Bakbuk, the sons of Hakupha, the sons of Harher, the sons of Basileth, the sons of Mahida, the sons of Harsha, the sons of Barkos, the sons of Sisera, the sons of Tama, the sons of Neziah, the sons of Hatifa, the sons of Solomon's servants, the sons of Sotai, the sons of Sophereth, the sons of Perida, the sons of Jela, the sons of Darkon, the sons of Gidel, the sons of Shephatiah, the sons of Hatil, the sons of Pokereth Hezabane, the sons of Ammon. All the temple servants and the sons of Solomon's servants were 392. And these were they who came up from Tel Melah, Tel Harsha, Cherub, Adan, and Immer. But they could not show their fathers' houses or their descendants, whether they were of Israel. The sons of Deliah, the sons of Tobiah, the sons of Nekoda, 642, and of the priests, the sons of Hobiah, the sons of Hakaz, the sons of Barzillai, who took a wife of the daughters of Barzillai, the Gileadite, and was named after them. These searched among their ancestral registration, but it could not be located. Therefore, they were considered unclean and excluded from the priesthood. And the governor said to them that they should not eat from the most holy things until a priest arose from Urim and Thummim. The whole assembly together was 42,360, besides their male and their female servants, of whom there were 7,337. And they had 245 male and female singers. Their horses were 736, and their mules 245, their camels 435, their donkeys 6,720. And some from among the heads of fathers' households gave to the work. Their governor gave to the treasury 1,000 gold drachmas, 60 basins, 530 priests' garments, and some of the heads of the fathers' households gave into the treasury of the work 20,000 gold drachmas and 2,200 silver minas. And that which the rest of the people gave was 20,000 gold drachmas and 2,000 silver minas and 67 priest garments. Now the priests, the Levites, the gatekeepers, the singers, some of the people, the temple servants, and all Israel lived in their cities. And when the seventh month came, the sons of Israel were in their cities.